you have an Android device, smartphone, or tablet whereby you cannot access the Android operating system, that is to say, upon trying to boot your Android device, your device crashes, hangs, freezes, the user interface of the Android operating system is completely unresponsive, you cannot boot your device, maybe you're stuck in a boot loop, maybe you only see the Android splash screen when you start up the device, maybe you're shown nothing on the Android device's screen. Essentially, if you cannot access your Android operating system, ideally what you would want to do is you would want to be able to access a recovery screen that you can therefore wipe your Android device, reset your Android device, reboot your Android device. Just another way of accessing the Android operating system instead of going through the standard boot up procedure. Well, this is what this video is going to show you. This is going to show you how to access the recovery screen or the recovery system of your Android device. Essentially, what you want to do is you want to first plug your Android device into a charger and you want to let it charge overnight. You want to ensure that you have plenty of battery power both on your Android device, essentially on the Android on the battery of your Android device. You want to ensure that it's fully charged and you want to ensure that you have a steady power feed going through to your Android device when you perform this. Once this is done, what you want to do, and now this varies from Android device to Android device, a precise Google search can possibly tell you which hotkey keys to hold, but essentially what you want to do is you want to hold upon boot a combination of your sleep wake on off button and one of the volume button directions, whether it be volume up or volume down. On this specific tablet, this Hipstreet Micron, the recovery system hotkeys to hold upon boot up are the sleep wake on off button as well as the volume up button. Essentially, you boot holding both buttons and you continue to hold both buttons until you see the Android recovery system. On your Android device, it could be sleep wake on off button and the down volume. There's different variations. For example, sometimes you have to hold these hotkeys and then release whether it be the volume key you're holding down or the sleep wake on off key upon viewing the first splash screen indicating that the Android device, whether it be tablet or smartphone, is booting up. It varies from device to device. Like I said, you could probably do a Google search for your specific device in question to discover what the hotkeys are. And once you access the recovery system, you have options such as, now these also vary from Android operating system to Android operating system, such as reboot system now, apply update from ADB, wipe data factory reset, wipe cache partition, reboot to bootloader, power down and view recovery log. Note that in the case where you cannot access your Android operating system, the solution isn't always to wipe data factory reset. Sometimes you should go for the simplest solution first before going to the gravest. For example, in my case, I was not able to access the operating system on this Hipstreet Micron tablet. For some reason, I was stuck in a boot loop where the booting of the device was always interrupted and it would always shut down. This was after a crash. What I learned is that going into this recovery menu and simply selecting reboot system now using the sleep wake on off button, in fact, allowed me to once again access the Android operating system upon this tablet. And by doing so, I was able to once again access my Android tablet as well as all of the data, all of the apps I put on it, all without losing anything. So that's what I recommend. I recommend you always choose the safest option first and go with the dire option last, which would most likely be wipe data factory reset. That is most likely the most severe option. In doing so, of course, what you're doing is you're resetting your Android device to factory defaults. You're wiping all of your personal data, all of your personal information, anything you personally put on the tablet yourself. And you'll have to start from fresh, you'll have to start anew as if you just took the tablet out of the box. Well, there you go. I'll leave you with that. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.